sir. This is a spotter provided to me, sir. I would like to provide a brief description. This is a young male patient presenting with the amputation of the right thumb. We can assume him to be a right-handed manual laborer, and the injury is suffered by a heavy blunt tool, and he is presenting on the same day of injury. On examination. Yes, sir.
Is it same day
Sir, only the picture is provided, sir, for the purpose of the...
How can you say same day? Show the previous picture. Show the what happened to the nail? Other fingers.
Yes, sir. There are remnants of trauma, sir.
All that has all healed, no?
Yes, sir. Healed trauma to the nail, sir.
And how can you say same day? Did you get my point?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So this is not same day on of the injury.
Yes, sir.
Maybe he is presenting 1 or 2 weeks after the injury, where probably the thumb has necrosed, and now he is presenting with this.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
He presents with the shortening of the right thumb, with the amputation at the level just beyond the interphalangeal joint.
You can't say shortening of the thumb. Just say amputation.
Amputation of the thumb, just beyond the interphalangeal joint or at the base of the distal phalanx.
Okay.
There is a transverse or slightly volar facing row area of 1x1.5 cm dimensions. Okay. And the cut end of the bone is exposed in the row area.
It's the base of TPX?
It's the base of terminal pharynx, sir. All the other fingers appear normal apart from the nails, sir. And the rest of the limb is assumed to be normal, and the other limb is assumed to be normal.
Okay.
So the available length is the up to the base of the terminal phalanx, sir. Now we have to go take an X-ray to determine the correct level of amputation.
Okay, it is at the base of the TPX. TPX about, say, 0.5 cm is there, base.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Next we have to take an X-ray to determine the correct level, sir.
That's what I said. Half a centimeter of TPX is there.
To diagnose the case, this is a case of amputation of the right thumb with Lister's classification of type 1 amputation.
Okay.
Or if you divide it into thirds, there is a distal 1/3 amputation. So the aim of the reconstruction will be to preserve the available length and give a sensate flap cover for the row area.
You want to see the movement of the TPX?
Yes, sir. To determine whether the tendons are still attached.
Okay. It is moving. It is moving.
Yes, sir. Assumed to be still attached, sir.
So you want a sensate flap cover?
Yes, sir. Preservation of the available length and a sensate flap cover.
So you are happy with the available length?
Yes, sir.
So you don't want normal length thumb?
Later, after providing a flap cover, sir, lengthening procedures can be done.
Why do you want to stage it? If something is available, always try to think what is the best option.
Yes, sir.
How old is he?
He's a young person, sir.
Young person. The which dominant hand?
Right hand dominant, sir.
Dominant hand, young person. So normally, if suppose it has happened to your own kith and kin, what will be your option?
Sir, if he presents immediately with a
he thumb is coming only now.
Sir, there are conventional and microvascular procedures to preserve or improve the length, sir, when the patient desires it.
Oh, what is the best option?
Osteoplastic thumb.
That is the best option for this.
If there are no comorbidities,
sir, is that available, Aswati? Sir, is giving yes, what is the best option?
Hello, sir. Sir, am I audible, sir?
Yeah. Continue.
Sir, the best available, considering the fact that he is young, and so and if it is a center where all the microvascular facilities are available, best option would be for him to have a second toe transfer, sir.
Second toe transfer.
Yes, sir.
For the thumb tip.
Thumb tip, or a wraparound great toe transfer, sir.
One, yeah, or I want one best option.
Second toe transfer, sir.
Second toe transfer will that will look like a thumb.
Yes, sir.
Sorry. So you tell us the options.
Sir, if the patient presents immediately, best option will be to re-implant the thumb, sir.
Okay. Try to implant.
Yes, sir. So
at this level, what will be the status of the artery? Where will be the vein? What will be the methodology by which you will do the replant?
Sir, this is the terminal phalanx level, sir.
So where will be where the dorsum? At what? What do you see? You see the eponychial fold in the amputated part?
We will see.
Is that the
eponychial fold will be there in the amputated part, sir.
But you see the eponychial fold here also, no? In the amputated, I mean in the hand. It's just at the eponychial fold only you see the amputation.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah, at that level. So, what is the difficulty at that level?
Sir, anastomosis of the vein will be difficult, sir.
Where will you find them?
Dorsally, sir. Dorsal vein.
Nail. Do you think so? Such a distal amputation, you will find the vein on the dorsum?
No, sir. Nail will be blocking.
Nail will be blocking what?
Vein will not be able to anastomose the vein, sir.
Where will be the vein? Where will you look for the vein?
On the lateral aspect, sir.
Lateral or volar?
Volar.
So artery, how do you classify fingertip amputations?
Sir, fingertip amputation can be classified by zone 1, by Tamai or Ishikawa classification, sir. It can be classified into 4 types. Type 1 is distal to the nail bed, sir. Type 2 is extending from the distal to the lunula to the distal to the nail bed, sir. Next is type 3. Type 4 is distal to the DIPJ joint. Type 3 is distal from the DIP joint to the lunula. Type 3 is from distal to the lunula to the tip of the nail bed. And type 1 is distal to the nail bed, sir.
What happens to the digital artery at that level?
It branches, sir.
Both digital artery, what happens to them? As they go towards the tip, what happens to the digital artery?
Digital artery divides into branches and forms a plexus with the opposite sides, radial and ulnar.
They divide and join, or they join and then give a central artery? Okay, let us not go into all those details. So on day one, if it is possible, you do a replant.
Yes,
suppose if it is artery is not good, or the replant is you have done or not willing to do, you are not technically qualified, facilities are not there, what else can be done on day one?
Sir, if the vessels are not good, we can take the spare, we can do a spare part surgery with the available bones, sir.
What is that called?
We can use that bone as a osteoplastic some replant.
So use the bone then?
Give a flap cover with the either groin or a local flutter.
A nail?
Nail can also be used, sir. It's a graft repositioned on flap.
What is that called? GRF?
GRF, sir.
Have you seen the pictures?
Yes, sir.
Who has done it maximum in this country?
Don't know, sir.
Don't know. Find out. That is one of the best technique if you're not able to replant. Or suppose the replant fails also, you can do that. Suppose day, fourth day, you find the replant is not working. At that time also, you can do that. Take the amputated part. You separate the nail bed, separate the bone, fix the bone, anchor the nail bed to the remaining eponychial fold there, nail bed, and give some flap, any flap, crossfinger flap, or any skin flap you give it. So
yes, sir.
Grab, reposition, and flap. Okay. So
yes,
that
sir.
Gives
yes.
almost 80 to 90% aesthetic appearance. You get it in those situations. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now we are left with that. All that is not possible. Now you have a defect. So now what is the best option?
Best option is to resurface the thumb, preserving the length, and give a sensate flower, sir.
You want to, you said second toe. Second toe, unfortunately, for thumb is a second option, not the first option. First option only for the big toe.
From yes,
big
sir.
Toe, what all you can take? What are the flaps available from big toe to reconstruct this?
Sir, from the great toe, we can take a wrap around great toe transfer, a trimmed toe transfer.
For the bone, what will you do?
Bone has to be retained on the great toe, sir.
So here in the for the thumb.
Or a toe pulp flap can be taken only for soft tissue covering.
Nail.
In a wraparound great toe transfer, we'll get the nail tissue also.
So it is called either a onychocutaneous or a partial toe transfer.
Yes, sir.
You bring the nail, you bring the pulp, you bring the bone also. It is partial toe transfer.
Yes, sir.
So whatever is needed here, that alone you bring it from there. Okay, so that will be ideal partial toe transfer. You said trimmed toe.
Yes, sir.
Will it be ideal in this case?
No, sir, because that much length is not needed, sir.
No, that's why you should not say that. Trimmed toe means you take the DIP joint also, IP joint also. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Only when you want that IP joint movement, you plan for trim toe technique. Here already the IP joint is there. You need only a little bit of bone and a nail and pulp. So partial toe transfer. Okay. So that is that should be your first option.
Yes, sir.
And for this osteocutaneous thumb reconstruction ball, I don't think it is advisable. You can cover that small area with any flap, So what is your, you said some Sensate flap, what flap?
Sir, from the homo digital reconstruction can be is preferred, sir. In that case, we can cover it with a Moberg flap.
Oh, you want Moberg flap?
Yes, sir.
So, can you, what is the disadvantage in this classical Moberg flap?
Thumb will be retained in a flexion, flex position, sir.
How to avoid that? What is the modification?
Not familiar, sir.
You have to give a bracket or a VY approximately, and that defect either close it or put a graft.
Yes, sir.
Is the modification. So that is Moberg flap. Okay. What else?
Sir, a propeller flap from the dorsal digital artery can be used to cover the defect, sir.
That is a Sensate flap?
No, sir.
Is that a Sensate flap?
No, sir. That's not a Sensate flap, sir.
Then why do you say that?
Because it is a homo digital flap, I put it before the other Sensate flap, sir.
I will agree for all dorsal defects and all. On the volar side, Sensate flap, probably you will have to think in terms of either same finger like straight triangular, oblique triangular, Moberg. These are the three options from the same finger.
Yes, sir.
Straight triangular, oblique triangular, and Moberg. Moberg only gives maximum movement. The whole volar skin, you can move it.
Yes, sir.
That is not possible. You have to go for other fingers. So other finger, probably littler flap.
Littler flap, sir.
Littler flap. Which finger you will take?
Sir, either ulnar side of either the middle finger or the ring finger. Sir, I would prefer a middle finger, sir.
Why?
Because both median nerve supplies the tip of thumb, and a patient will require a sensory re-education, sir. But
so ideal is to take it from the middle finger.
Yes, sir.
Another advantage, it is a longer finger, so the reach also will be very easy. Okay. So how will you cover the donor defect of Littler's islet flap?
From an FTSG, sir.
What precautions you will take? Suppose you are left with a elliptical raw area or a oval shaped raw area on the ulnar side. What precautions you will take and why will you do that?
I will cover it with a full thickness skin graft, sir.
Full thickness. Any particular technique you will do to avoid something? Yes, you are shown in that picture that the full thickness graft is not an ellipse.
Yes, sir.
Some extension is there. Why?
To prevent contraction, sir.
Yeah. So it's very common to have, especially on the flexor side, any graft, even full thickness graft, it can contract. To avoid that, make it zigzag. The edges, you make it like a small Z. You try to cut it, back cut, and make it zigzag. Don't make it straight.
Yes, sir.
That is a Littler's neurovascular flap.
Another option is to take a staged island flap from the staged island flap from the middle finger, sir.
So, who described
that? Here, sir. Professor R. Venkat Swami and Professor Professor R. Venkat Swami. Yes.
Yeah. So what do you do at the second stage?
In the second stage, sir, flap is divided and the nerve is neurotized. The flap is neurotized. Sir.
Yeah.
Here, sensory.
When you are not competent enough to do a island flap, probably you can plan like this. But there's a second stage is a big advantage. They will get a sensation like a thumb sensation itself.
Yes, sir.
Okay. That is one advantage. Sir. But I don't think it is nowadays frequently practiced. It's almost given up. Or we have plenty of other options, especially microvascular options. Anything else?
The cross finger flaps from the index finger can be used, sir.
Cross finger can be done.
Even cross finger can, can be provide a sensate flap cover, sir.
FTMA?
FTMA, sir.
Okay, okay.
Hello, sir.
I'm not able to hear you.
Hello, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yeah, yeah.
Sir, yeah. Some disturbance is happening, sir.
Yeah.
I think we have covered almost everything. So we... Yeah.